I have no idea why it is parodying Natural Born Killers. That's a real stretch. It's also not in 3D. I don't understand that. And the fact that this exists at all is even more confusing. This is Natural Fawn Killers. It's a game made in 1999 by a company calling themselves, well, back then it was Fiendish Games, which was actually a subsidiary of Criterion Software. Yeah, that same company that also went on to make Burnout and a bunch of other good stuff. They also experimented with smaller teams with smaller projects like this one. This, supposedly a hunting spoof parody thing, like Deer Hunter, and I guess, I don't know, because really, it's not really a hunting game so much as it is a sadistic animal murdering simulator. That's the entire point. You're a psycho hunter named Harry who just takes pleasure in destroying animals and collecting their carcasses. The entire goal is to shoot anything that's living, make it dead, and fill your little sack thing at the top right before the timer at the top left runs out. And that's it. You get 10 levels of the same thing. This was actually donated to me in physical retail form by a person calling themselves Martin, a viewer on YouTube who was generous in giving me this awfulness. Seriously, though, thank you, because this game is odd and not exactly easy to come across, which is something I always like to have in my collection, even if the game is awful. It also features rabbit sex, and that's quite impressive, actually. I'm sure that's a selling point to someone out there, although I don't want to know who, so don't tell me. I'm attempting to see if these two rabbits will do it, because they do. Although it is quite tempting to just shoot their stupid little faces right off. Yeah. Here we go. Here they go. Yep. Only here on LGR Plays and Natural Fawn Killers. You now have more rabbits to hunt.
I got something!
Why it sounds like you just jumped in a pool, I have no idea. I have no idea about any of this! This is so amazingly subpar. Yeah. And if I sound kind of bored with this, it's because I am. I've been playing this for about 2 hours now. And it's not because I want to, it's because I am reviewing this. Well, not necessarily this one, but another one that followed this up. You'll see this weekend, or whatever. Your friggin' hunter guy never shuts up, and man, is he obnoxious. I love how your gun never moves, too. Reloading animations? Nah, that's ridiculous. None of that.
I've got you, bitch.
I'm not entirely sure who the intended audience of this is. I guess just, oh, you know, budding sociopaths in their mid-teens. You know, antisocial. You know, potentially thinking about shooting some people in a public place, but, you know, it's still working on the whole animal cruelty thing, but doesn't quite want to fulfill it in real life. Either that, or people that are just completely friggin' bored, and or, like, smell at you, mother, that's really genius. People that are completely friggin' bored, or just like to collect and check out very strange games and shooters. And my goodness, there are a lot of them on the PC. This is one of them, and, yeah. I'm not going to go into extreme detail about all the things that are wrong with this game. Not in this video. That'll be for the review, but, yeah, it sucks, man. It sucks. And I don't normally just go out and say, this game sucks. This game sucks, though. At least as far as game is concerned. If you don't want to treat it like a game, I guess it's not the worst. I have not seen any other thing like this, really. I mean, yeah, sure, it's a hunting game, but it's not. There is no hunting here. You can use calls, yes. Like that. Sounds more like he's just kind of clearing his nasal passages and whatnot. Oh, great. I'm stuck in the ground again. You can't jump. Okay. Good grief. That's another thing that's wrong with this, but anyway. As I was saying, the hunting is useless because, yeah, calling animals doesn't really seem to do anything. They're completely stupid. Like, the AI is just terrible with these things, so it doesn't matter. You're just going to find them. You run faster than they do. They're supposed to be able to smell you downwind, but it doesn't matter. Because even if they did, you couldn't, you're not going to have any kind of real challenge. Speaking of no challenge, here's a minigun. The worst sounding minigun in the world. Just listen. Yippee-ki-yay, mother. I swear my toothbrush sounds 100 times more menacing than that thing. It's not even an electric toothbrush. It's just a regular toothbrush. Brushing my teeth. And I feel more threatened. This is just... Oh my goodness. And this isn't even as bad as the one I'm going to be reviewing. No, it gets worse. Because at least these levels look kind of nice. Kind of. You know, they're green. They have some color. They kind of look like somewhere that would sort of exist. Yeah, you filled the vat. So glad. So glad. But yeah, it gets worse than this. I'm just going to go ahead and say it. I'm going to review the Christmas version of this. There is a Christmas version of this. Oh, freaking holy crap, there is. I love not having crosshairs. Isn't that great? That's awesome. Run, run. Oh, would you stop bleeding and just die? Alright. I think there's bears in this level. I need to see if I can actually find a gun that's worthwhile, because this sniper rifle is actually the worst thing in the game. And, nice floating tree there. Well, halfway. Man, I hope you're not still watching this, because this is truly dreadful. It's just, I don't know what they were trying to do, and that's the thing. Like I said, it's not a hunting game. It's just a game where you go around murdering stuff in these, like, friggin' barren, ugly landscapes with these terrible weapons and crappy animal AI, and there's zero challenge. Here we go. This is almost amusing. Watch this. There you go. Yeah, you can use a grenade launcher and, use a grenade launcher on bunnies. This is amusing for about a minute. Also amusing is the fact that, you know, it will, it blows up deformable areas of terrain. That's kind of cool. That's due to the simplicity of the game engine. Yeah, smell it, you mother. You smell it, you mother. My goodness, what an idiot. I hate this guy. Yeah, the levels are actually not... geometric or, like, made in a level editor, per se. Well, I'm not sure if not geometric is the right term, but basically, you have a 128 square pixel image. It's a bitmap. You can make these levels in MS Paint, and that's how the levels are made. It's like a height map system, and then you have some super basic textures that are just layered on top of that, along with these wonderfully rendered objects. Yeah, this gun is honestly the best part about the game, and that is not saying much. That's like saying, you know, well, the best part of a nuclear holocaust is... Yeah, it doesn't matter. It's a nuclear holocaust. It still sucks. But at least you can watch bunny corpses fly into the air. Yeah, definitely made for the simple-minded, easily entertained, bored user. Wow. I'm sure I would find some sort of enjoyment out of this when I was like 12, but... Maybe. I mean, I had Duke 3D and Unreal. Well, almost had Unreal back then, so... yeah, I don't know. Alright. I can't stand much more of this. Let's try to take out this stupid bear that actually looks more like poop with legs, to be honest. Alright. Taking these guys out is incredibly easy, since if you run backwards and just shoot them, you'll eventually take them out, because you running backwards is the same speed they run going forwards. So, again, no challenge. It almost would be a challenge, because, you know, they can kill you, and then you'd have to start the level over again. And as you can see, I'm back to run out of time on this level, too, so... You'd have that. That's not so tough now, are you? Technically something challenging, but it's more like... have you been lucky enough to spawn near animals that will give you enough meat points? That's it, because otherwise,
picking up the pieces.
Yeah, there's nothing to it. There we go. See, I failed. You get to start over. Screw this game. Alright, well, I'm done with this. I hope you didn't enjoy this, because I honestly don't want to meet or know of the kind of person that thinks this is awesome. Because it's not. And, in any way at all. Really, there is nothing about this that is intriguing, because every single potential possibly fun thing about this is done in any number of other games way better and in a much better package. This wasn't worth $15 back then. It's not worth seeking out now. But I am thankful for having it, because it is actually quite a rare game. So whatever, I will end my rant here. Thanks for watching, I suppose. My apologies for the awful crap. And stay tuned for my more in-depth and a little more or less rambly review that's coming like December 7th or something. Yeah, that's all. That's all.